I have full autonomy as far as what I do in my classroom or how I structure my syllabus. So for my first two semesters, I sort of kept with the materials that I'd inherited from Bonnie, sort of seeing how they were working, but I've since changed things quite a bit. For example, when I first came in, one of the things that Bonnie wanted to do was to have a notebook assignment because she felt that the JVP students didn't really understand how to take notes, how to maintain a notebook. They didn't know what these good student behaviors were at Western universities, collecting and organizing handouts and label dividers, and really the whole notebook thing was just lost on me, and my students didn't like it at all. And as I've said, I've learned that the JVP teachers were already giving them some of these organizational academic strategies and preparing them for higher ed. So I got rid of that. I got rid of things like that, and I try to use time that I would have spent on that to focus on the course content. I also got rid of nearly all of the handouts that Bonnie had used. I decided I wanted them to live in the book. It's all in the book. It's all in the book. So when I give a handout, it's a worksheet that the author has designed, and he's referencing the pages in the book that you need to turn to complete those questions and sort of walk you through the process of outlining a speech or presentation. And that's been a major change that I've done. And now I give them Blackboard assignments to keep them on track with reading so that they come to class ready to talk about it. It's all in the book. The truth is, reading is one of the biggest, you know, I have no freaking idea what they're actually doing with the book. I really don't understand their relationship with the book. I read my evaluations from last term, and several students said they really liked the book. It was one of the most useful things from the class. And yet, when I asked those students questions from the book, they couldn't retrieve the information. I never thought they were reading the book. And when they took the final exam, which, you know, I did a very simplistic rendition of the final exam, so my final exam was almost half the length in terms of the number of questions that I would have for mainstream students. The multiple choice options were, to me, so obvious. I didn't do the kind of complex structuring of prompts and responses. I didn't mix synonyms with vocabulary terms. There were antonyms, and you've just got to choose. If you know it, you know it. You're not going to pick the antonym. They didn't do well on the exams, and everything was right out of the book. I really have no idea what they're actually doing with the book. I don't necessarily crack the book during class because I've got what I've tried everything. I've tried giving them, for example, a summary handout of the chapter. I have PowerPoint slides that I've pared down from the author's 36 or 48 slides a chapter to 12. I'd simplify the language a bit. I've tried going through the slides the week before the class when they're supposed to have done the readings so that they understand that these are the highlights of what you're about to read. So when they do read, they'll read for examples. So then, when I ask you in class, what is a question of fact? Give me an example. They can. It didn't really work. I don't know. So then I've tried, okay, just read these pages. These are the pages to focus on. Read them twice. And then we come to class and we work through the PowerPoint together. So, okay, here we've got, here's the definition of a question of fact. Let's come up with some examples. And of course, it's just the same two or three students providing the examples in every class. They've done the reading. They've done it. And then I'll do a reading quiz afterward to make sure that the other student who may or maybe didn't do the reading or who read it but didn't have all the connections yet, I'll do a quiz in class. And so 50% of them will get it and 50% of them will bomb it. I don't know what else to do.